So I saw Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Out of the Shadows. Hi everyone, I'm Brandon Prosek and this is the So I Saw Show, reviewing the latest Ninja Turtles movie. You may remember my most watched review from back in 2014 when I reviewed the original rebooted Ninja Turtles movie that, yeah, I hated and kind of slammed in my review. If you want to go ahead and go back and watch that, I just remember being severely pissed at the director, Megan Fox being involved, and many things that beyond that. But it's a new movie. It seems like they listened to a lot of the criticisms. Let's jump in. Before I get started, if you haven't seen the review show before, I like to talk about the bads, the goods, and give you my overall rating. I'm going to talk about some of the bads first and then move on over to the goods. First bad thing, whenever the turtles weren't on screen, I usually was not into it, like at all. Especially f***ing Megan Fox. I'm sorry, there's nothing that they could do with her character to make me like this version of April O'Neil. The only thing that made it better this time around was that she was in the film less. If you've seen the trailers, there's this image where they hike up her shirt to kind of reveal her midriff, and they try to make her seem all badass, and it was like random because the whole movie is sort of has this cartoonish vibe, and then they randomly wanted to make her like a sex symbol for like 2 minutes. Stephen Amell as Casey Jones, I wouldn't say his casting was bad, it's just they didn't write Casey Jones very well. But the number one terrible thing about this movie is the script. It's a very run-of-the-mill, hey, there's an evil thing, and the good guys gotta stop them, and then they do. One thing I didn't like about this direction was this movie was going a million miles an hour. The runtime is about an hour and 50 minutes, but it felt like they were trying to race. Oh my gosh, there's this, and then this leads to this, and this action sequence to this. It's like, slow the f*** down. One of the other bad things that I mentioned in the story is that it's not just with this movie, it's not just with the Ninja Turtles, it has to do with the Marvel Cinematic Universe, a lot of superhero and action movies nowadays, that everything builds up to this big Act 3 final battle that's just filled with a shit ton of CGI. Like, we've seen it over and over. Do something different. One of the best things about Civil War is that the final fight was a personal battle. It was between Bucky, Cap, and Iron Man, and it was more about the characters and the emotion than it was the action. Even one of the most hated Turtles movie is Ninja Turtles 3, where they go back in time to the like feudal Japan. Like, that story was different because in the end, it wasn't about the final battle, it was about them getting back home to present day New York. Ever heard of that, writers? Like, do something different. For once. This is not like my review from 2014 Ninja Turtles movie. I'm going to talk about some more good things. So I'm leaving on the bad things, jumping on over to the things I liked. The turtles. The thing I hated about the movie from 2014 is that there was not enough turtles. It was too much Megan Fox. And that made the movie better, huh? Surprising that when people pay to see a movie called Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, they want to see the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. I think all of the performances of the turtles were fantastic. The guy, especially the guy, I think his name is Noel Fisher, who does Michelangelo. Hilarious. I loved Mikey. I loved all the turtles. And this film looked a lot better than the last one. On the turtles' faces, you actually saw emotion. I can't go on with this review without mentioning it, but Bebop and Rocksteady, played by Gary Anthony Williams and Sheamus from WWE. These guys, like I said, they're goofy, and what I liked about it is they fully, you can tell these two were having fun together. They had chemistry, which was odd. Like, I heard they were casted, I was like, those two? Of all people for Bebop and Rocksteady? But it worked for some odd reason. Because I'm coming down to my overall rating, let me just make something perfectly clear. This is by no means a good, like, amazing movie by any means. The story, like I said, is just sloppy. It's something you've seen 100 times over. Have you been a fan of the Ninja Turtles in the past? If so, go on and see it. If you haven't been a fan of the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles in the past and any of the incarnations, don't go see it, because this movie's not going to win you over. Right, guys, so that brings me to my overall rating, which, like I said, even though I had a fun time and I love the turtles, I can't just, you know, I can't let it go by how sloppy the script and story was. So I'm going to give it my number 3 rating, which is glad I saw it in theaters. I'd probably buy it on DVD for $10 or less. What did you guys think of Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 2 Out of the Shadows? Did you like it? Or am I totally wrong? If you guys could do me a big favor and hit this red button right below, subscribe to the Entertainment Buffet channel. We got some new content coming your way. Every other Monday we have Movie Trailer Trash, where Charlie and Bethany Duber examine movie trailers and judge the movie solely based on that, where they guess the Rotten Tomatoes, all that kind of stuff. It's a fun show. Check it out, guys. If you'd like to see some other movie reviews, I've seen Captain America Civil War, I've seen The Nice Guys, I've seen X-Men Apocalypse. Check out some of my other reviews over here. Click any of these if you'd like to see my thoughts on those. Alright guys, thanks for watching. And now you saw the So I Saw Show.